But we as a church, while waiting for his second coming, we will remain unfazed, and our life and our hope will not be succumbed by our pain. If you're living with health problems, remember that in heaven there is no sickness nor death. If you lose your home, Jesus said, "In my Father's house are many mansions." If you felt that you are underpaid, Isaiah 65:22-24 said that what? They will work and they will get the reward. They will work on their vineyard and they will reap the harvest of their labor. When you think that this word is a sin-cursed word, think that Jesus Christ will create new heavens and new earth for me. If you think that your prayer is not answered, and it seems that God is silent on your petitions and your prayers, remember, the book of Isaiah says that before they will ask, I will answer them. If you lose something that is precious in your life, remember that God has lost the member of the Trinity, Jesus Christ. If you lose your way going to heaven, looking for the right direction, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. While we are living here on earth, 6,000 years ago, this river of human plight and suffering is continuing to what? To flow. But this river will not end in the ceaseless ages of eternity. This will end in the ocean of God's promise, when God will usher his kingdom, that Christ will come again for the second time. And all of our sufferings here on earth will just be a moment and crime of our life, but it will be rewarded. Those who will press on this promise will be rewarded of great eternal life. On that day, those whose life is threatened by the plight will fly into heaven. Those people, those members of the church, the part of the remnant church, whose lives are always nailed daily to the cross of Christ, will sail to heaven. Those whose shattered dreams in this land has been broken will be ushered to the promised land. But while we wait for that second coming, we will just sing the song, "My hope is built on nothing less and than Jesus' blood and righteousness." Church, do you have blood? Do you have a personal river where you are treading today, that you're experiencing in your journey? Remember that this suffering and human blood will not be there permanently and perennially. God will end up this river of human blight on the day of his promise. And look forward. If you lose your job, if you lose your home, if you lose your family members, if you lose your hope, and you turn desperate right now, think further that the ocean of God's promise is greater and wider than your river. To end up this statement, may I read to you the book promise in Isaiah 40:31. This is the last verse of Isaiah 40, which is the beginning of the promise given to this book. It says here, "But those who trust in the Lord," I like the translation in other versions, it says, "But those who wait for the Lord," my Bible says, "those who trust in the Lord." I like both, because you cannot wait if you don't trust God. And while you're waiting, you need to trust Him. "But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles." They could see the horizons. They could not only see the things here on earth, but they could see the things beyond this earth, because they could look forward and move forward on the promises of God in heaven. They will run and not grow weary. They will run and not grow weary in their life. They will walk and not faint. Yes, church, you're old. You're suffering from lot of setbacks after setbacks until you're waiting for a comeback. Maybe you are old enough in the church, but let this promise reverberate in our minds as we ponder upon it, that those who will run the run of life will not grow weary, and those who will walk the walk of faith will not faint. May that promise reside in us, reside in this church, as all of us will join together our thoughts and our desire to wait for the second coming of Jesus. God bless you today.
Amen. Amen.